डियर लर्नर्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर अभिषेक घई, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट यूनिवर्सिटी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ होटल एंड टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट, पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी, चंडीगढ़। आई एम टेकिंग मॉड्यूल ऑन द टॉपिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ फूड एंड बेवरेज स्टाफ। अंडर द पेपर फूड एंड बेवरेज सर्विस ऑपरेशंस एंड मैनेजमेंट। आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग दिस मॉड्यूल द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू लर्न अबाउट द कैटेगरीज ऑफ स्टाफ, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हायरार्की ऑफ F&B सर्विस डिपार्टमेंट, रोल ऑफ की स्टाफ ऑफ द F&B डिपार्टमेंट, qualities required for food service staff. First of all, I introduce about the topic organization of F&B staff. Staff organization is basically concerned with the matters such as the decisions of tasks within the restaurant, position of responsibility and authority and the relationship between them. It helps in introducing the concepts of span of control, level of management, and delegation of power and responsibilities. The typical organization restaurant chart of the restaurant brigade is discussed in this chapter as well. However, smaller organizations may combine a number of responsibilities according to the needs of the particular facility. All types of catering establishments require a variety of staff positions in order to operate effectively and efficiently. The food and beverage service department usually has the largest staff. Leadership and supervision is required to effectively direct the department and guide the staff. The personnel in the food and beverage service industry require practical knowledge of operations, as even a small error can cause displeasure to the guest. Coordination of activities of all outlets is essential to provide the guest with quality service at all times. Teamwork is the watchword in any food and beverage department. A dedicated and committed team with able leadership under ideal working conditions helps in fulfilling the establishment's ultimate goal of guest satisfaction. Staff organization plays a major role in the success of any establishment. It is also important to have well-disciplined operation in an outlet. It helps the management to allocate the right persons in the right positions. An effective staff organization is necessary in service-oriented industries such as hospitality industry. It is important to know some techniques of human handling while managing or organizing staff. Every successful organization has different level of brigades to perform various operations. The food and beverages service personnel can be categorized into three levels. Number one, managerial level. Number two, supervisory level. Number three, operations staff. Now, I talk about number one, managerial staff. This category of staff is on the top in an organizational chart. They are known as top management. This category has lesser number of people who participate in decision making. They are responsible for the overall performance of an establishment. Number two is supervisory staff. This category of staff takes the middle part of an organizational chart. They are also called the middle management. This category fills about 15% of the total number of staff working in an organization. Their main responsibility is to supervise, the lower staff and communicate them the decisions made by the top level management. Number third is operational staff. This category of staff is at the bottom end of an organizational chart. They are the ones who actually have hands on the job. Most of the physical work is performed by this category of staff. They make about 80% of the total staff in an organization. If I talk about the organizational chart, what is an organizational chart? An organization chart is a diagram or format in which the job positions are arranged in an order of their level of hierarchy. The organization of the food and beverage department is evolved over the years and assures proper distribution of work in the food and beverage service. The authority and responsibility delegated ensures that the work is completely satisfactorily. What is hierarchy? Hierarchy is a term that denotes the task and authority relationship in an organization. It clearly shows the reporting relationships of the members appointed at various levels of responsibility, and also shows formal lines of communication. Hierarchy is a system in which grade or class of positions or authorities are ranked one above the other in an order. Why there is a need for hierarchy? Hierarchy basically deals with decision-making power, responsibility, authority, and relationships between two positions. It helps in introducing delegation level of management and span of control. Without hierarchy, it is difficult to function smoothly and fulfill objectives of a business. Hierarchy or organizational structure is made based on the duties and authority. What is duties? This is a list of activities to be performed by an individual under the conditions of employment. The duties are determined by the employer and may change from one organization to another. It becomes the responsibility of the individual to deliver or perform as agreed in the employment contract. What is authority? It is a right to acquire action from others and the ability to get things done. It is only possible when the individual has sound knowledge, skill, and personal attributes. The level of authority is determined by the employer based on the above discussed qualities. One should clearly define the chain of command or the line of management when framing an organizational structure. In other terms, this is called hierarchy. This helps in better assignment, integration, and delegation of responsibilities and duties. Now, I discuss about the organizational hierarchy of food and beverage service department. When I talk about the organization of F&B service department, topmost person in the hierarchy is food and beverage manager. Under that, there is assistant food and beverage manager. Under assistant food and beverage manager, there are outlet managers like restaurant manager, banquet manager, room service manager, bar manager, kitchen stewarding manager. Under these managers, there are superior staffs, as I discussed, the supervisory staffs and the operational staffs works under these managers. Now I discuss about the role of key staff of these staff. First of all, I talk about the role of food and beverage manager. Depending upon the size of the establishment, the F&B manager would be responsible for implementing agreed upon policies or may set up catering policies. In general, he is responsible for ensuring that the profit margins are achieved for each food and beverage outlet of the hotel and for the each financial period. He or she compiling new wine list according to the current trends, modernization and needs. He or she responsible for purchasing of food and beverage materials. He is responsible or ensuring value for money is maintained in the department. He is responsible for the portion size of the item or dishes. He is responsible for the departmental training and promotions of the staff. He is responsible to maintain highest professional standards. He is responsible for employing and dismissing staff. He holds the regular meeting with department heads for efficiency and coordination. Now I talk about the restaurant organization. In restaurant organization, the topmost person is restaurant manager, or in French we can say directeur de restaurant. He works under F&B manager. He reports to F&B manager, assistant F&B manager, general manager, or in smaller organization, owner of the restaurant. He is responsible for the operation of dining rooms. He is responsible for hiring, training, scheduling of staff. He maintains service standards of the outlet. Takes the briefings of the staff. In absence of senior captain, he handles guest complaints. He helps in menu planning, cost control, and sales of the outlet. He carries out management policies in the outlet. Restaurant manager supervises various staff like maitre de hotel or senior captain, captain, waiters, hostess, busboys, stewards. He coordinates with executive chef, controller or chief cashier, sales manager. The skills required by the restaurant manager is he or she should have the thorough knowledge of food, drink and service techniques. Directs personnel, plan and forecasting meet public. He can handle problems and complaints. Under restaurant manager, the next staff is number 2 is maitre de hotel or head waiter or senior captain. He reports to restaurant manager, GM and owner in small established restaurants. He supervises overall operations. Senior captain supervises pre-preparation for service. He is responsible for reservations, greeting and seating of guests, training and scheduling of staff, duty rotas of staff, maintains service standards. He takes the briefing. He handles guest complaints. He is responsible for sales, planning of menus, and controlling. He relieves the restaurant manager on his day off. So, he is the next person who is in charge of the restaurant after restaurant manager. He supervises captains, waiters, busboys, wine stewards. The skills required by the senior captain, he or she should have the thorough knowledge of food and beverage. He should have a good memory. He must know more than one language. Under senior captain, number 3rd is maitre de hotel de carré or station head waiter or captain. He she is responsible for ensuring smooth operations of a section of the restaurant comprising up to 4 stations. He should making sure he has adequate staff to carry out work during the operations. He checks the grooming of the staff working in his section. He briefs the staff on service procedures, seeing that the area is clean and tidy. He inspects the table to see if they are correctly laid and the proper cover setup should be laid down on the tables. He checks if the sections have adequate table linen or place mats or disposals, like nowadays disposable napkins are being used in the restaurants. He checks the sideboard if they are equipped with adequate stock required during the service or during operations. Number fourth is station waiter or steward, or in French we say chef de rang. He reports to maître de hôtel or senior captain. He's the overall responsibility of section of 4 to 8 tables from one sideboard. He takes orders and serves food and beverages. He is responsible for proper filling up of sideboards to check whether there is a proper flatware, cutlery is available. He supervises waiters and busboys. The skills required are the good knowledge of food and beverage. He should be efficient and speedy in service. Number 5 is demi chef de rang or junior station waiter or assistant steward. He, she assists the station waiter in service. This designation may be found in an upscale restaurant that needs highly personalized service. Number 6 is commis de rang or waiter. He, she assists the station waiter and the junior station waiter. He, she does most of the basic mise en place work. He is responsible for various tasks like cleaning and wiping cutlery, crockery and glassware. He collects the cleaned table linen from laundry or linen room. He fetching food from the kitchen, assisting with clearing the table of dirty items and carrying soiled crockery and cutlery to wash up area. Number 7 is sommelier or wine waiter or wine butler. He is responsible for the service of all alcoholic drinks during the service of meals. He is also a salesperson. He can do or he does do upselling in the restaurant. He requires a thorough knowledge of beverage and wines as food accompaniments. The speed in service is required as maximum sales have to be effected during a meal period. The remaining requirement is the same requirement as of the waiter. The next one is banquet organization. There are various designations found in the banquet department. Number 1, banquet manager. In the overall hierarchy, he works under food and beverage manager. He or she is in charge of all the functions of the banquet department. He is responsible for discussing function arrangements, details with clients concerning menus, table plans, costs, wines, bands, toastmasters, etc. Communicating date of function, time, number of guests, and all other necessary details to all the departments concerned is his responsibility. Number 2, banquet head waiter or senior captain. He is in charge of banquet hall and is responsible for many things like engaging staff on casual basis for functions. Casual staffs are paid by hour and are given a meal. Their services are terminated at the end of the function. Usually, they use the regular outsourced staff. Maintaining list of casual staff and their contact numbers is the duty of a senior captain. Further, the executing the function according to the instructions of the banquet manager is the responsibility of a senior captain. The briefing of banquet waiters, getting the hall set for the function is the responsibility of a senior captain. He is responsible for supervising the mise en place, allocating duty to the staff, maintaining stock, maintaining logbook. Number third is dispense barman. This is a requirement of dispense barman in banquet organization. A temporary dispense bar is set up during the function in banquet premises by the dispense barman. He may be either on the permanent employee role of the banquet department or temporarily sent by the bar for the function. The outsourced bartenders as well be recruited for a day to operate the dispense bar. He is responsible for collecting stock of alcoholic drinks from the main bar against requisition, allocating bar stock to various functions, setting up of bars with necessary bar accessories like straw, stirrer, lime juice, sugar syrup, garnishes, etc. He is responsible for organizing bar staff, allocating duties to bar staff, controlling of bar stock and cash during the service. The next outlet is room service. In room service organization, the topmost person, number one, is room service manager. He or she is responsible for preparing budget for the department, compiling room service menu card, liaising with the chef and the food and beverage manager. He prepare sales report, analyzing sales for managerial decisions on menu planning and pricing. He handles guests' complaints and establishing good relation with them so that the guest will return back in the hotel and the retention rate will increase. Procuring equipment required for room service department. Recruiting and training staff is the role of the room service manager. Coordinates with other departments as well, like for with front office for the VIP guest. Controlling labor cost, making sure that the department has adequate supply of materials and provisions required for room service. Monitoring performance of staff is the role of room service manager. Number two is RSOT, that is Room Service Order Taker. He, she is responsible for taking order from the guest and sending it to the room service captain. He makes sure that he picks up the call within three rings. He or she do the suggestive selling. He referring to the room list to know status of guest, room positions, validity of the order and plan in which guests are staying. He helps in preparing the bill. Number three is room service captain. He or she is responsible for receiving orders from the order taker, collecting dishes from appropriate section of the kitchen, checking tray before being taken to the room, supervising the mise en place activities of the department, preparing indent for room service requirements and getting approval from the room service manager. Ensuring cleanliness in the department is the main role of the captain. He briefs the room service stewards about the VIP guest, not available items. He maintains the logbook. He prepares the duty rotas for the room service stewards and other staff. He ensures that the trays are cleared from rooms. Number four is room service steward, room service waiter. Room service waiter is called the chef d'etage in French. He is responsible for lining trays and arranging them with basic service equipment and accompaniments. Setting up room service trolley, collecting proprietary sauces, disposables and so on from stores. Collecting dishes from hot plate, still room and arranging on tray. Carrying tray to room and serving if necessary. Collecting signature of guests on bills and handing it over to room service order taker, who in turn will send it immediately to front office for charging to guest accounts. Further, I talk about bar organization. In bar organization, the topmost person is bar manager. The bar manager is responsible for all functions of the bar and the dispense bar. The responsibilities of a bar manager includes recruiting staff and training them for bar operations, supervising alcohol service, forecasting volume of sales, maintaining a close watch on movement of bottles is the main role of a bar manager, preparing budget for bars, formulating beverage control system in bars. He makes sure to maintain quality of services in operation. He is responsible for handling guest complaints. Number two is head bartender. He or she is responsible for the overall function of the bar, and his duties are supervising bartenders, scheduling rotas and day off for bar staff. He is responsible for receiving stock from the cellar against the requisition. He is responsible to maintain a par stock level, certain level of inventory in the bar. He is responsible for training bar staff in making cocktails, mocktails, preparing glasses for drinks, garnishing drinks, service procedures, recording orders, etc. He is responsible for taking closing and opening stock of the bar. He is responsible for maintaining empty bottle records. He assists the bar manager in his daily duties and relieving him during his day off and holidays. Number third in an organization is bartenders. They are responsible for mixing and serving drinks to guests seated at the counter, or we can say seated at the front bar. He is responsible for pouring required measures against beverage order ticket or for bar waiters to serve guests at the table. He is responsible for washing glassware and bar tools and equipments. He is responsible for recording sales. He is responsible for receiving cash from guests or getting bills signed by residential guests, taking note of their room number and signature on the bill. He is responsible for establishing good relationship with customers. He is responsible for taking opening and closing stock. Number four is bar waiter or waitress. They are responsible for keeping the mise en place ready for beverage service at the table. He is responsible for recording beverage order on BOT and collecting them from the bar. He is responsible for serving guests alcoholic drinks at the table in bar, restaurants or lounges. He or she is responsible for clearing glasses and leaving them for wash in the washing area. He is responsible for collecting payments from the chance guest or getting the bill signed by residential guests. There are qualities that must required for food service staff, like number one, personal hygiene. This is most important for the service staff as they are constantly handling food and beverages and often go near the guests. To ensure proper personal hygiene, all staff should be indulged in that. They should bath twice a day or at least once to avoid body odor. Brush teeth and use mouthwash daily. Have regular dental check up for good dental care. Wash hands frequently, especially after the use of toilet. They should not sneeze, cough, or blow nose near food and in the work area. Not use handkerchief in the restaurant. They keep shoe well polished every time. They wear clean and well laundered uniform. Number 2 is punctuality. Staff must report to work on time with proper uniform and good personal appearance. Punctuality reflects the interest of the staff have towards their work. If the staff does not report to the duty on time on regular basis, it shows lack of interest in the job. Number 3 is honesty. It is of paramount importance, especially in front of the guests. Rude behavior towards guests or arguing with damage very quickly the reputation of the establishments. And guests' property tells lies to his colleagues and guests pass on vital information to competitors, etc. But it is important to remain honest in the face of such temptations. Number 4 is loyalty. The staff should be loyal to the organization in which they are working. They should not badmouth the organization or colleagues to anyone or promote the competitor's business. Number 5 is conduct. The conduct of the staff is very important, especially in front of guests. Rude behavior towards guests or arguing will damage very quickly the reputation of the establishment that has been built over the years. Rules and regulations of the establishment must be followed and the senior staff must be given due respect. Number 6 is personality that should be possessed by the F&B staff. The staff should be diplomatic, tactful, courteous, even-tempered, and not controlled by emotions. During service, wait staff come across various challenging and demanding situations that should be handled diplomatically, satisfying both customers and management. They must converse with guests in a pleasing manner and have the ability to smile at the right times. Number 7 is local knowledge. The service staff must have sound knowledge of the area where they work. This will enable them to answer any queries of guests on entertainment, places of interest, shopping area, transport facilities, and many more. Number 8 is memory. Good memory is an essential asset for service staff. They should be able to remember who has ordered what, who is sitting in which table number, which room number a guest is staying in, the likes and the dislikes of guests in case of regular guests, where they like to sit, what type of food they prefer, what type of drinks they take, they smoke or non-smoke, smoker guest, name of the guest, and many more. This will help the service staff satisfy the guest to great extent. Number 9 is team spirit. Almost all activities in the food and beverage service areas are carried out by a team of staff. No staff member can think of doing all the activities by herself, himself, and be successful in his job without the support of other members of the staff. So the teamwork is very important in service sector. Therefore, It is necessary that the wait staff have the ability to get along with everyone. They must help colleagues to perform better in their jobs and complete work as a team to satisfy customers. Number 10 is communication skills. Again, a main component that F&B staff should possess. Very good communication skills is necessary for the service staff, not only to suggest, explain and serve the dishes to customers, but also to have good interpersonal relationships with the guests. It is always an added advantage to know the local language and any foreign language to interact effectively with guests. Talking to guests in their own language instead of just English is very effective and build good relationship. Now, I summarize the topic by saying that F&B department is the second major revenue producing department of the hotel. The activities of this department are highly complex, demanding varied skill levels to perform the job. This department not only takes up the responsibility of providing food and beverage services, but also organizing various types of functions, events, conferences, and many more. The style of or the type of people engaged in executing the food and beverage products and services should be given adequate training on various aspects of catering services. The organization structure varies from hotel to hotel, depending on the quality of staff, technology in use, production and service processes, and so on. The organization must clearly communicate to the employees what they should do and should not. The staff should have the right attitude and should know what is expected of them and how to fulfill the expectations satisfactorily. High labor cost is always related to quality and quantity of manpower. It is also the responsibility of the department heads to ensure that the labor cost is within the predetermined level, and it does not mean one should reduce the labor cost by terminating the experienced staff and recruiting new people. Unfortunately, many operators indulge in this kind of practice without realizing the fact that few experienced staffs can do much better work than a large number of new recruits. It should also be understood that raw hands need more of supervisors and managers' time, which may not permit them to do their work. So, and that was all from my side. Thank you and have a nice time ahead.